Hey guys, it's Mark Oakley here again with another episode of From the Drawing Board. And today, it's early March or mid-March, and I thought I'd say hi to you and tell you what was going on. Today is a day when it's called a star drop day, and I've got the next episode, on the drawing board here, and I've got a bunch of the characters more or less penciled. But first, I wanted to take you for a little walk. So this here is my wood stove, and I haven't got it fired up at the moment. I just woke up. I spent the night through the wee hours and then slept, and that means your wood stove goes does that. It burns down to just ash. Now, this is a video mostly for city folk, because I moved up here from Toronto. And I'd never had a wood stove before, so this is my first season using one. And so for a lot of people, especially for people in the valley, they're like, yeah, it's like they're not going to be necessarily understanding or really get why I'm fascinated by this technology and how it works. It's kind of like, if someone had never had a kitchen sink before, never used taps, and were making a video for all their friends back home who also didn't have taps. Like, look at this, and then this one's hot, and this one over here is cold. And then everyone's, oh, that's really interesting. But so for anyone who's familiar with wood stoves, feel free to fast forward through this video or just skip it altogether. But for those of you who aren't, this is the coolest technology ever. I mean, it's very, very old, of course. I think it might be the first technology that after like hitting things with rocks, like the lever, the big step was fire, right? And we haven't really done a whole lot to it. We just burn stuff and we, benefit from the heat. But the actual technology has come a long way. Like, this is a very, very high-tech device. I think it's kind of wasteful. I mean, people, it seems very inefficient. Like, a lot of heat goes up this chimney and out the top. You can take care of that problem by doing things like winding copper pipe around the chimney, which just bakes, and then run water through that system, and then do something with the hot water, run it, well, you've got hot water to work with, and that's that's a huge benefit. And so you can like bleed the heat off and heat rooms and pipe it around stuff. But so this is not the most efficient system, but it's really great because even the 40% or whatever we do get out of it fills this space and heats the whole house, and it goes upstairs. So when the fire's going, after just a couple of hours, the whole house has this nice, really rich kind of heat, and I loved it. The alternative, because we have regular pipes that pump water, that'll kick in. We have an oil furnace down in the basement, and a great big tank, which I should go check later, make sure the oil levels are right. But when the heat drops below, you've got a thermostat. And so to prevent the pipes from freezing, you keep it set at like 10 minimum, and then you do the rest of your heating with the wood stove. The furnace also, the oil heat also heats water so that you can have a hot shower in the morning and that sort of thing. So the oil tank does go down, but oil is expensive. It costs about, it's almost $1,000 to fill that tank. It's much more efficient to burn wood. So I've tried, while the landlord is away, the property owner, he's in Europe or Mexico. He's all over the world. He spent 8 months traveling. Anyways, I've been trying to make sure that we keep, the temperature above 10 degrees using wood. And that way the furnace doesn't kick in unnecessarily. And so I'm like, okay, that's good. Anyway, I ran out of wood, I guess, a couple of weeks ago. Maybe I was burning it inefficiently because the landlord he bought a couple of cords of wood, and a tree outside came down or was cut down, and we cut that up, and so we had all this fuel, and he assured me that it was not, that's fine, that'll get you right through into the spring. And I, you know, in the winter, I was like, well, we had guests over, so people were up a lot, and the wood stove was always going, and it was always nice and toasty warm, and they were just, everyone was just tossing wood in the fire. And then when they were gone, I would sort of, I put a few logs in when I was heading out, just to make sure that, you know, the heat, it didn't, you know, didn't burn out, and the oil tank would kick in. And I think we were using more wood than Gary would normally have been using in his own time here. Plus, he's very conservative. He's one of these guys who, like, turns every light in the house out except for the one directly over his book. So he knows how to live very frugally. And I think maybe my wood use is not reflective of his wood use, or reflective in a way where my wood pile goes, it runs out before the snow stops falling. So I was like, okay, not a problem. Since I am benefiting from the heat, I'll just buy a pile of wood. And so this is from the pile of wood. Let's see. I'll take you outside. Yeah, let's go outside. Come on. One of the things about this house in the countryside here is that you see. I don't know if you can see that. The light's pretty low in here. Let's change this to. I guess we'll just leave it. So these are my regular boots. And I thought these would be great because they're leather, nice thick sole, but these are city shoes, man, or town shoes. This is what everyone in the countryside wears, these slip-ons that are just really rugged, insulated. They're just super easy. Anyone wearing a pair of these that you see in town is, you know, they have a house in the countryside or they're a farmer. And I resisted for a while because you kind of hold on to your towny kind of dressing aesthetic, you know, your fashion sense, and you kind of resist a little bit. But when I got here, eventually the sense kicks in. So, you know, what you do is just whip that around your ankle, pop it in, boom, you don't have to tie anything up, you're ready to go, and they slip off really good. So good winter boots. And I, you know, the same kind of boots that you wear in the summer too. All right, so here we are outside, and as you can see, there's some ice on the ground. We had some rain, and it got really, really warm. Can you hear that? That's me walking on ice. It got really warm. I thought that I wasn't going to need any wood, but I ordered some up, and it was about $250 after taxes. A guy in a truck showed up, and he just said, "Where do you want it?" I said, "Oh, just you know, just dump it behind Gary's car here." So that car's been sitting there for a while, and I don't know where the keys are. I think Gary hid them so I wouldn't go cruising around town in his absence. But which I wouldn't. There's my car there. And but you know, you want to turn the engine over every few weeks so the oil doesn't sink down. So I'm hoping it's going to be all right when he gets back. But I should maybe email him and find out. Where, you know, I guess I could have solved that. Anyway, so here's my pile of wood, and it's got a tarp on it because it was raining, and I didn't want the wood to get wet. Although it came, I guess, kind of wet. It was freshly cut, so it's been difficult. You have to dry it. That's why around the wood stove, I had them sort of stacked up, so when I was burning through the last remains of my dry wood, the heat from the stove would dry the new wood out. So you kind of have to get this little processing plant going. It works for the most part, but you got to check this out. This is too. This is for city people, right? Terminology. They've heard of, like, oh, it's a cord of wood. I didn't know what a cord was. Well, I'm going to show you. All right, so I just put these on to keep it from blowing away. Whoa, it's trying to kill here. Anyway, so my God, that's like, okay, look at the size of my car. And then look at the size of this wood pile. That is one cord of wood. That's a lot of wood, man. So I got the stuff. In fact, like, you know, it filled the whole back of this great big sort of dump trucky thing. It was like sort of between a pickup truck and a full-on dump truck. It was like, that'd be the vehicle in between. Actually broke the guy's vehicle. He came to dump it, and he was parked right here. And he goes, okay, where do you want it? Oh, just dump it right here. and things started to, you know, lifting up, and then clunk, it looked like it was going to tip over sideways. This big metal pin had popped out of a piston. So we spent 20 minutes, just me and this guy, trying to, like, we could see the pin, because there was the back of his truck here, and then, like, maybe 2 inches, 3 inches over was the back, you know, where the front end of the lifting part. And the pin was just sitting on this little platform, you know, this greasy little super dirty thing right in, and just sitting there. And you could see the hole that it was supposed to go in, and we were like, how do we get to it? Because, you know, my arms aren't super thick, but I couldn't get down there, and he was this big burly dude, he couldn't get in there either. So between us with a couple of sticks, we're trying to like lift this heavy object and guide it into a hole. Oh man, it was impossible, right? We couldn't do it. So in the end, what we did was he was able to lift get the piston up partway, and then we jammed some hunks of wood under the sort of the lever part, so that when the power was taken off, it would crunch down and leave a space. And I'm like, okay, we're just trying to make enough area so we can get our hands in. And I'm looking at this greasy, dirty, big machine, and I'm like, okay, you know, after 20 minutes of being frustrated, I'm like, okay, dude, we have to take a minute, take a beat. Today, and I said, today, neither of us are losing any fingers. And he looks at me, holds up his hand, and he's got like one finger's gone. He goes, too late for that. Like, he's, in my line of work, you lose fingers. I'm like, oh my God. Anyway, we safely got it in, dumped the wood, and here I am. And I got to get this in, got to get this all stacked away so that Gary can get his car out before he gets back. So that's going to be my job over the next couple of days. And so yeah, that's what I wanted to show you guys. And that's one cord of wood. Now, a house like this is two or three cords. Like, I think we burned maybe three cords of wood over already. So, you know, me wanting to be warm, might be a 3.5 cord house for a busy winter with lots of guests. Yep. Anyway, that's what I wanted to show you guys. I'm gonna get to work, maybe get some wood going, and sit down, do some cartooning, and get the next star drop up. So that's the video for today. Thanks for watching. Hit subscribe and like and all that stuff, and hope you guys have a great day. Stay warm this spring. Love you all. Bye.